Hello, Classic Crew, and welcome to today's video, where we're going to be talking about 12 things every classic lady should own. I'm so excited to share today's video with you guys because I think that there are certain things that most modern people don't own, or at least don't have like a nice, pretty, dainty, feminine version of. And having these items makes you feel like a classic woman, and it is the nicest feeling. So I really wanted to share these things with you. I will say that these are things that I've collected, and these are things that I didn't have growing up, nor did I even have before I was married. Some of these I was actually introduced to by my husband, and then I just found maybe some feminine versions of them, or I'm just using other things that he brought into our marriage. But it's things that I love having as a lady and as a woman, and it will make you feel much more ladylike and feminine and make your home feel beautiful to have these small items just in your house to use whenever you want. And I'm so happy I own these things, so I really wanted to share them with you today. I'm really excited to get into this list. I will link what I can down below, but I'll also link some things that I just think are pretty and that I think you should try. So I'm really excited. Let's get into it. The first item I think every classic woman should own is a ring holder. So my mother-in-law actually gave this to me when Jacob and I got engaged. It was a place for me to put my ring, which I thought was so sweet. And this is such a classic piece to own and to have and to use in your house, because every time you're in your kitchen and you're about to do something with your hands, you're gonna wanna take off your rings. So this is just a beautiful piece that you could get, but you can get different kinds of ring holders that are all different styles. And they're just little dishes that you can put your rings in. And it's a place where you'll always remember that that's where you put your ring instead of just putting it willy-nilly anywhere. And then, oh my goodness, like, where did I put it? I forgot. No, with a ring holder, you always remember. And it's also nice for guests because when they come to your house and if they need to wash their hands, they have a place to put their rings. So I really love having this. This one is just really beautiful, but you can get any kind of style, and it's definitely a great addition to your home. The next thing I want to talk about is something I actually have to get from back here, and that is perfume. I think a classic woman should have at least one kind of perfume that's just her scent and that lingers on her skin. And I absolutely love this Toca Simone perfume for the spring. So I've gotten this question from a few of my followers, so I wanted to mention it here. If you're looking for a spring perfume, I think this is just absolutely lovely. It's Toca Simone, and I think this is a lovely scent. It doesn't last on the skin forever, so if you're looking for something much more long-lasting, this wouldn't be it. But this is a great scent for spring, and it's such a pretty bottle too. And having a perfume bottle that just sits on your countertop, it's so pretty and feminine and delicate. So I think that having a perfume is absolutely necessary if you want to feel like a lady. The third thing I want to talk about today is a thimble. So I actually got this thimble from an antique store, and I absolutely love it. I think it's so beautiful. And I never had a thimble, but I would sew and I would hurt myself because you're poking through the fabric with a needle and you don't have anything to stop it. And having a thimble is actually really useful, but you can get such beautiful thimbles from so many different places. You don't have to just use the plastic one that comes in your little kit. You can also get them from antique stores, from vintage stores. Really, there are so many different places, and this one was, I think, 99 cents or something, and I just love it. So owning a thimble, it may not be popular, but it's something that I think every woman needs, and I think every woman should know how to do just a little bit of sewing, at least to put on a button. I mean, I just think that's useful. So learn how to sew, number one, and then number two, get yourself a thimble. The fourth item is slippers. I think having a comfy pair of slippers to walk around the house in is such a nice little luxury. And these are Uggs, but I also have a pair from Target. You don't need to go fancy with your slippers, but just having a pair that you love, that you think are pretty, and that are comfortable, and that keep your feet warm, so that when you're walking around the house, you don't have to have bare feet on cold hardwood or whatever else it is. Having a nice pair of slippers is just so classic, and it's so nice. I mean, if you want to go really classic, you can get the really fancy vintage looking slippers that are like a little heel and have a little puff on the front. Those look great. Those are really feminine and really fancy. And they're the kinds that women would wear back in like the 40s and 50s with long nightgowns. Ugh, stunning. So I would absolutely be a proponent of that. But even if you just want to have just the nice little luxury of having just comfy and cozy slippers, that is something I think that every classic woman should definitely own. Oh, were you wondering what the next one would be? It's a pocket mirror. Having a pocket mirror is the nicest thing because I think looking into your phone camera is, I hate it. I hate looking at my phone camera to check my makeup or to check my teeth. Having a little pocket mirror that you can just kind of check things and it's a mirror and not trying to use like your front-facing camera is so much better. I love this little mirror. I got it when Jacob and I got married. And of course it says Mrs. on the front. So I think it's just really cute. And you can get these anywhere. You can get them at vintage stores and get a really beautiful one, or you can get a more modern one, but having one of these in your purse is just really useful and helpful, and it means that you don't necessarily have to go to the bathroom. It means that you don't have to use your phone. You actually have the thing that you need, which is a little mirror in your purse. The sixth thing on this list is a butter dish. I love this butter dish. I've mentioned it on my channel before. I got it on Amazon. I love the color. It's like Tiffany blue, but having a butter dish is so nice. I never used to have a butter dish growing up. My parents never had a butter dish. They didn't leave butter out. And so we would always have to be scraping the butter off for our toast. And it was the worst. You'd dig holes in the bread. I hated it. And when I got married to Jacob, Jacob always had a butter dish and he would always leave out his butter. And it was so smooth and nice to put out on our bread. It was just easy to spread. And so getting a pretty butter dish, it's just such a nice addition to your kitchen. And if you get one that you love the appearance of too, you'll like it being out on your counter. And I love the appearance of this. So having this out on our counter makes me really happy. And it also just is so useful because I can actually have butter that is ready to spread. So I recommend having a butter dish if you want to be more classic. Oh, what time is it? Well, it's watch time. So number seven is having a watch. I've mentioned this again on my channel before, but having a watch I think is one of the more classic things you can do because it means you don't have to look at your phone to get the time. If you're sitting at lunch with someone and you check your phone, it just looks horrible and it looks really rude a lot of the time. But if you glance at your watch, it's just a little bit more subtle. You can also do it, you know, in a way where they don't really notice. But also just having a watch on is always a nice addition to any outfit. And having a beautiful watch, one that you love, one that goes with whatever you're wearing, is a really nice addition to your jewelry closet, to your wardrobe. And I think having a watch is one of the most important accessories that men and women should have. I think that all people should own watches and wear them regularly. Now, do I wear a watch every single day? No, but if I'm going out with people, I try to put on a watch just because I think it's useful and it's nice to be able to reference the time without pulling out your phone. Number eight is an apron. So this is an apron that I got on Amazon. It's really cute. It has a little cross in the back. And I really think having an apron is important. If you're not wearing an apron when you're cooking, things will splatter on you and then you have to do twice as much laundry. And who wants that? So having a really nice apron that you think is cute and makes you feel pretty, that's just a really nice addition to your kitchen and to your life. And also, if your apron gets dirty, that's what it's meant for. That's what it's supposed to do. I felt bad when I got a stain on this apron, and then I realized that's why I bought it, was so that it would get stains on it and I wouldn't get stains on my clothes. So having a pretty apron in your kitchen is a wonderful thing that you will always feel good about putting on when you're about to cook. Let's talk about coasters. So this is number nine. These are our coasters that we got in Omaha. And I love these coasters, but we have so many coasters around our house. And having coasters available to everyone in your home when they come and they want to use a dish and they want to put something down is a really important thing to have as a classic woman, because you want people to feel comfortable putting things down on surfaces. And if there's coasters available for everyone, then they won't have to ask you, they won't have to worry, they won't have to forget, and then maybe leave a water ring on a table that you really didn't want a water ring on. So having coasters is just really important. I think these are not the most feminine, these are just fun, but if you want to get some really feminine, beautiful coasters, there are so many different kinds you can get. Amazon has great options. I'm sure you can get them pretty much anywhere if you take a look. And having coasters available and ready is just a great thing to have. Number 10 is pearl earrings. I've got them right here. I love these pearl earrings. I did a sponsorship with the Pearl Source a few months ago and they sent these and I love them. And I think every classic woman should have a pair of pearl earrings. Pearl earrings are so beautiful. They're so classic and they are a great addition to your wardrobe. They go with pretty much anything. You can dress them up, dress them down, and having just a pair of pearl studs is always going to be a great part of your jewelry collection. So I definitely recommend having that as a classic woman. Number 11, I'm going to say this without actually owning it, because I think I should own it and I'm upset at myself that I don't. And that is a letter opener. I think having a letter opener is such a beautiful classic thing to own. I think you can get really beautiful ones. You can get ones that are your style and that will make every letter you open feel special. And I don't actually have one and I regret that, but I wanted to mention it because I wanted to show you guys. I don't always get everything right. I am not perfect, but I aspire to be more classic. So I would like to own a letter opener. I think that would be a really classic addition to my life. And I think that every classic woman should own a letter opener. So I will link a few down below that I'm interested in purchasing and you guys can check those out. And the last thing I wanted to mention is a schedule or an itinerary. I love having an itinerary. I love having my calendar and being able to lay out the whole month and then also be able to go day by day. I know many women do it on their phones. That's also fine, but I find that having the written out paper version of a calendar is so important, and it makes me better at sticking to my schedule throughout the day, and it also makes me better at remembering appointments. So I think that having a really beautiful, whatever style you like, because there are a million styles of calendars that you can get nowadays, really beautiful schedule and itinerary for yourself is a really nice thing to do. And speaking of a to-do list, a schedule, I have created a template of one that you can get a free download of if you subscribe to my newsletter. So if you head over to the link in my description box, you will be able to subscribe to my newsletter and you will also get a free download to a to-do list and schedule template that I designed. So if you're interested in doing that, feel free to hit that link in the description box. But that is it for today's video. Those are my 12 items I think every classic woman should own. I'd love to know your thoughts. Let me know if I missed anything. I'm sure there are many things that I didn't talk about today, and I'd love to hear what you guys think a classic woman should own. Thank you so much for watching today's video. Please subscribe to my channel if you haven't already and hit that notification bell. If you would like to subscribe to my newsletter and get that free download, feel free to head to my description box and hit that link. If you'd like to follow me on social media, it's Classically Abby absolutely everywhere. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye!